0.0.255. So this network comes under the area 0. Next, the direct connector network for R4 is 150.10.2.0. So this network comes under the area 30. Network 150.10.2.0. Wildcard mask is 0.0.0.255. So this network comes under the area 30. Do write to save this configuration. Okay, now we can configure the R5 router. So in the global mode, we can give router space OSPF. Here I will use the process ID as 5. Next, I will mention the router ID, router hyphen ID 5.5.5. Next, R5 router direct connector network is 150.10.2.0. So network 150.10.2.0. So wildcard mask is 0.0.0.255. This network comes under the area 30. Do write. It will save the configurations into NVRAM. Okay. Now we can configure the R6 router. So we can go to the R6 router. So in the R6 router, in global mode, we can give router space OSPF. Next, we can give the process ID. So in R6 router, I will use the process ID as 6. Next, the direct connector network for R6 router is 189.200.1.0. So this network comes under the area 10. Here I will give 189.200.1.0. So the wildcard mask is 0.0.0.255. So this network comes under the area 10. Sorry, before that I will mention the router ID. So router hyphen ID 6.6.6. So do clear IP OSPF process. Yes. So before it forms the neighbor relationship, we should assign the router ID as statically, otherwise it automatically chooses the router ID. Once it will choose the router ID automatically, means we can clear the IP OSPF process, then only it will reset the router ID. Okay, do write. The configurations can be saved into NVRAM. Okay, now we can go to the R7 router to configure OSPF routing protocol. So in the global mode, we can use the command router space OSPF. Here I will use the process ID as 7. Next, I will mention the router ID statically, router hyphen ID. So 7.7.7. Next, R7 direct connector network is 172.15.100.0. So this network comes under the area 20. So the net area is 172.15.100.0. So the wildcard mask is 0.0.0.255. So this network comes under the area 20. Do write to save the configurations into NVRAM. Okay, so in this topology, all the routers, we can assign the IP address and we can configure the OSPF routing protocol. So now all the router can form a neighbor relationship, and all the router can learn all the networks. Let's we can check. Go to the R1 router. So in the privilege mode, we can give show IP route. Here we can see it will learn the other network also. Here IA indicates the OSPF inter area, because area 0 is a backbone. Within the area, it will form the neighbor relationship, it will learn the networks, means it will display the O. If the area 0 can learn the network comes under the area 10, so this is an other area, so that's why only it will shows the inter area. Let's we can check. Yeah, we can form here. It will learn the 3 network. area 10 network, area 20 network and area 30 network. Here we can see this is area 10 network, this is area 20 and this is an area 30. So all the routers can learn all the networks. Okay, now we can use the MD5 authentication. So using MD5 authentication only will forms the neighbor relationship. For what purpose we can use MD5 authentication? Means for security purpose we can use MD5 authentication. In EHRP routing protocol we can use the keychain. So in that keychain we can use lot of keys, but here we cannot use any keychain, just we can use the key individually. We can use the key to create an MD5 authentication. Okay, now we can configure the MD5 authentication from area 0 to area 20. So in area 0, say this is an area border router. So this router is area border router, means it will connected to the area 20 as well as area 0. That's why only it should be an area border router. So here we can configure the MD5 authentication. So first of all we can go to the R3 router, exit. Okay, first of all we can go to the particular interface. So R3 router can be connected to R7 router through the port serial 0/0. So we can go to the R3 router. So in that R3 router, in the global mode, we can go to the particular interface, interface serial 0/0. So now we can configure the MD5 authentication. So the syntax for configuring MD5 authentication is IP space OSPF space authentication space message -digest, enter. Next we can